So I have to speak for 5 minutes on epidemiology risk factor and screening guidelines in a scenario where, you know, eye examination is not a part of our newborn health systems. It is not being taught to the newborn caregivers. It is not being taught to the eye caregivers. And that is one of the main reasons why there is an epidemiological outburst of this disease. So I'm not going to talk about the world epidemiology, but I'm going to talk about our subcontinent, especially India. So I always wonder why the disease, which was first described in 1960s, you know, in Boston when the first incubator came. So it's not an ancient disease, it's an iatrogenic disease. But the knowledge has not been transferred to our NICUs, whether it is in Bangladesh or in India, whereas world experts have been involved in setting up these SNCUs. More than 700 SNCUs have been set up in India in the last 5 years, and we were not even aware of it in the ophthalmological community till all these blind children started coming to us. And this is our graph to show that we are actually in the midst of a huge epidemic of ROP blindness. And you can see the data from our hospital. The childhood blindness from every other cause, whether it's vitamin A deficiency, glaucoma, congenital cataract, has remained stable. But the ROP blindness has, you know, massively increased. So we don't need any, you know, world data to say that we are in the middle of an unprecedented epidemic. And you can see here the surgeries when I initially started were very few. These includes laser surgery. And I thought, you know, I'm operating more because Dr. Gopal has gone to Singapore and nobody else is there to operate. But that's not true. Actually, all the centers in the country are now flooded with, you know, blind babies. I used to see one blind baby a month. Now I see 8 to 10 in every OPD. And that is because suddenly all these, you know, child care centers have been set up and none of them have an ROP program. So the only good ray is that in India, at least the NNF came up after a lot of effort of Anand, myself, and other people to set up a national guideline. And this is one of the first national guidelines in any disease in our country. And these are the guidelines, and this is what we need to follow in all the developed countries. Less than 34 weeks or less than 1750, they said, and less than 36 weeks and 2,000 grams if risk factors are present. And in the same document, they wrote that without risk factors, they are not sure whether to screen or not screen, and they need more evidence. But what we do is, because it's difficult to know whether the baby is 1750 or 1800, our weighing machines are not that great. So we just say 2 kg or less. If it is preterm, term babies 2 kg or less, they are IUGR babies, they don't need screening. Or if any baby who looks preterm but gestational age is not known, they must be screened within 20 to 30 days of birth. And this is based on solid data. It is not just because I say it or Anand says it. This is the data published by Claire that in Western world, the ROP is limited to certain groups, but because of varying neonatal care, as was alluded recently, and also could be based on many other factors, one of which is the large number of preterms which are born in our country. You know, all this IVF treatment, low nutrition, whatever, we still get a lot of, you know, ROP, even where the risk factors don't seem to play. And that is depicted in the number of babies who cross the Western guidelines. So we have our own Indian guidelines. So what I want to highlight is that there are a lot of risk factors which are told for ROP. But remember that these are not risk factors for ROP blindness. The ROP blindness is not directly related to the risk factors for ROP. The ROP may occur, but this data, which just got the IGO Platinum Award, shows that, you know, before our program started for screening, we used to see a lot of these babies, and almost all of them came in stage 4 and 5. And with the same risk factor and same gestational age, just because we started screening, we just reversed the trend in our twin cities of Hyderabad and Secunderabad. And now we don't see unscreened stage 5 in our city. It very rarely we see, and if we see, we audit that patient in detail and find out why he missed the screening. So the risk factors for ROP are oxygen, sepsis, you know, bad care and things like that. But the risk factors for ROP blindness mainly are delayed screening. And we have the evidence why the delayed screening is occurring. A lot of it is because the children were never told to go for screening. And even those who were told to go for screening were not told it in a way that could be understood by the parents as the seriousness of the issue. There is no media information, there is no information on the walls of the NICU. So the public who is suddenly saving their babies in these 700 SNCUs has no clue, even the staff doesn't have any clue that they need eye checkup. And this is an area that we all need to actively work, you know, about the advocacy and the awareness. And as I said, we need to build a team. You cannot have a blame game that, you know, you didn't send, I was not there. You know, in areas where there is no information, they have no idea, we have to build that team and we have to lead from the front. And we need to improve the coordination if we want to bring down this epidemic. So various things, one of which is the CME, but a whole lot of things we need to do. as ophthalmologists, because these children are coming to us, this beautiful baby, you know, one of the twins, 28 weeks, really a marvelous job by the neonatologist. They're not interested in creating blindness. They want to have healthy babies. But then information is not there in their curriculum or in their toolkit or in their program. They were not told that, you know, these babies need eye checkup. So what we say is, 30 din roshni ke, 30 days to vision, you know, just screen them at 30 days. Set up one day, screen them, and tell your front desk staff and your telephone staff and the parents that this is an emergency. They don't need to take an appointment, at least in my areas. They can just come and screen, because it hardly takes 10 minutes to screen them. There's also the challenge for the ophthalmologist, because here is a, you know, very nice diagram put up by a retina surgeon, actually, where he's drawn things very nicely, and then he has interpreted it by saying, you know, there is no ROP. And I made the same mistake 20 years ago. You know, so they just to say, you know, this child, according to cryoropy, is a success story, because he has 21-25 vision, can write very good. But this is not what we want. What we can achieve is absolutely normal retina if we screen them on time and treat them before the retinopathy becomes a vitropathy. So these are the screening guidelines. So there are myths in the community that, you know, my children don't get ROP, I am doing very good work, it's not my responsibility. And, you know, they always keep on saying, no, eye specialist is willing to come. And the eye specialists are not willing to come because they're not trained. It's not in the curriculum. And, you know, the parents don't follow instruction. But I think it's very, very important to build that team and have the screening done on time. So here is Biju Raju. He's a leading light for us because he fought the system. He screened his own child. The NICU locked the gates, didn't allow him to come in, but he fought and he treated with a trepid heart. You know, he was very scared because he'd just come out of his fellowship. But, you know, he could give good care, including kangaroo father care to his baby. And today that baby is seeing very nicely. So I think what we need to know about the epidemic of this ROP, the screening guidelines, is that 30 days to light, they have to be screened on time, they have to be followed up, and the program has to be owned by the child care practitioners. How many of you would have thought that the polio program would have worked if it was, you know, owned by the orthopedicians and neurologists to whom these lame and, you know, handicapped children go? It would not work. It would work only because the pediatrician and neonatologist owned it. So, you know, as ophthalmologists at the receiving end, we are owning it, we are driving it, but it has to transfer to the ownership and, you know, holding up by the pediatrician and neonatologist. So that's what I wanted to say.